Hi, I'm Jack Horton, and I'm an Esri instructor. I'd like to show you a boundary line adjustment in the Parcel fabric. And first, let me show you what it's not. Here I have the Move tool, and if I just move a Parcel line, all I'm doing is perhaps improving the quality, but I'm not making any change to the land record. This movement didn't create a historical parcel. It didn't get recorded as a record change. It merely moved the line and perhaps put it in a better location, but it certainly didn't do anything to the land record. Let's undo that. Let's just discard our edits. And let's do a true boundary line adjustment. So to do a true boundary line adjustment, we need a record in the parcel fabric to keep track of the fact that the owners exchanged money for land at the boundary line. So I'll create a record. And you can name it as you need to. You can also specify the type. That's an editable list. And let's record the date that it legally occurred on, not the date that we do the edit. Let's create that record. Okay, now we're going to select the two parcels that will have the boundary line adjustment. And there's a really nice tool in the Records tab called Copy Lines 2. And what this does, it makes historic parcels as soon as you do that, and it copies the lines that were in the selected parcels. And then you can manipulate those lines to make the new parcels out of them. So it's doing that. It brought the lines in. It already made the original parcels historic, and it made seeds where the parcels used to be, retaining their attributes. So now I'm ready to do the work. First, let's go ahead and divide these lines. So I'll select this line and divide it 100-foot piece and a 5-foot piece. And let's finish that. And then I also want to divide this line down below. And so I can just select it. And it remembers what I did before, so I can just hit the divide button, and it'll divide that one too. All right, so now I need to move this boundary line. Now I could, if I chose, just delete it and make a new one. You know, it's up to me what I want to do. But in this case, I'll just move it. And so now I'll find the Move tool. And before I move it, I need to turn off the topology. Recall that things rubber banded with the topology on. Well, I just want to move the line. I don't want to drag everything with it. So now I'll move the line. Put it right there. Now notice it doesn't seem to be snapping right. So I'll hold the control key down on the anchor and slide the anchor down, snap it to the end. And now I'll move it and I'll snap the anchor into the end point of the lot lines there. That should do the trick. Okay, let's complete that. So now the line's in the right place, and assuming things are snapped together right, when I build, I get good parcels. We'll find out. Let's go to the Records tab, and let's go ahead and build the active record. Now what this is doing is it's expanding these seeds to fill the area contained by the lines, and then it's going to turn on the rest of the fabric that was turned off. And if you'll recall, the historical parcels already got created when I did the copy lines too. So at this point, it'll pretty soon turn everything back on, and you'll see everything like it's supposed to be. Okay, there we go. There's the historic parcels, and there's also the new parcels. So that's how you do a boundary line adjustment in the parcel fabric. All right, one last thing. Perhaps I should go ahead and turn the topology back on, because I'll probably need it next time I do some editing. All right, thank you.